esteemed colleagues. When we were presenting this, preparing this presentation, we extended the group of patients because patients with pericardial involvement are of interest as well from our point of view. Hence, we've taken not only just angioplasty, but all vascular atrial type surgeries, including angioplasty. So, and try to analyze our own result. To do this, we used the regional cancer register. 724 patients were extracted from it. You see a men amounted to 88%, women almost 12%. Age range was 24 to 81, with a median of 58.9. All patients were divided into four groups, mainly group 1, combined operations of vascular atrial type, 170. Group 2 surgeries, including tracheobronchoplasty, 162. Group 3 standard surgeries, 167. And group 4 chemoradiotherapy, 225. Morphological structure of the tumors was quite evident and standard, nothing special. Squamous cell cancer and adenocarcinomas prevailed. Others could be met very rarely. This is a very sad slide. In our region, we are dealing with the highly advanced stages of the disease. There were many patients with the involvement of regional lymph nodes and very many patients with grade 3, 4. Vascular atrial type surgeries. Here we selected only primary pneumonectomies and lobectomies that were combined with the resection and or plasty of the upper vena cava, left edge resection of the pulmonary trunk on contralateral right. Technologically, these are the options of vena cava resection. 37 and all, the first option, our favorite and reliable, two processes installation, sub option, left processes plus the patch of the vena cava left. That's the bypass, which was not very reliable from the point of view of intraoperative safety, so we denied this option, and a very rare option when we left only one processes, either left or right. Edge resections, 14 of those were performed. Pulmonary artery resection, different options, most often it was edge resection. As said, 14 such operations were performed, but in some cases, when pulmonary artery didn't allow that, we had to such a patch or circular resection of the vessel. Left pneumonectomy with the resection of the entry and edge resection of contralateral artery and pulmonary trunk. To avoid critical narrowing of contralateral pulmonary artery, we had to such a patch. Only left operations were included into this study because on the right such operations cannot be performed. Left atrium, we have taken only true resection of left atrium. One of 107 interventions like this. And aortal resection, full layers. Three operations, off pump, on pump, and this was the first resection. Chemo, radiotherapy. We were interested in this group as a control group when we assessed the long-term result. 40 and 60 are very conditional figures. Certainly these doses may look and will look differently if we analyze the groups deeply. The groups were representative but not comparable. Earlier stages were merged into standard surgical groups, so tracheobronchoplasty had a bit more patients compared to angioplasty. If we speak about surgical complications, the number and types of complications were practically the same, but in the vascular atrial types of operations we didn't see complications specific for this surgery. The atria were not ruptured, the vessels were not torn, fortunately. As for mortality, it was quite high. But we've heard this similar data from other authors. The causes of the deaths for fistulas, hemothorax, or very badly controlled the intral bleeding due to pronounced dystrophy of pulmonary artery wall. But it wasn't enough variant of angioplasty. Acute pulmonary failure and distress syndrome was met quite often, meaning that not all the patients can tolerate such a scope of operation, thromboembolism, and in all, we had 26 or 16% deaths. Long-term results, if we take the groups how they've been selected from the regional register, the control surgical groups showed the best options. Gamma radiotherapy demonstrated the best option. Well, vascular atrial type, it occupies an important intermediary space between chemotherapy and radiotherapy. If we look at non-small lung center and only grade 3, between all surgical groups, the difference, long-term difference was annulled, and the gamma radio group is an outsider, very low survival rates, at least in our region. M2 patients, vascular atrial subtypes, the patients do not differ at all from the other groups, while surgery, including tracheobronchoplasty, show the results a little bit better. Angioplastic lobectomies, we compared them with the standard pneumonectomy. We were happy to see these results, practically no difference. If we look at pneumonectomies of a vascular atrial type compared to standard ones, there are no differences, but angioplasty shows was resolved in for all stages, but only in stage 3. We've seen no difference in long-term result. We were interested in the result. In the result of what were the main factors all this depended for. We've taken as predictors the main characteristics, like gender, age, TNM, grade, morphology, trials on left atrium resection. Resection of vascular atrial type are substantiated, but we have to be very careful and very carefully select the patients for such surgeries. Angioplastic lobectomies, from our point of view, is an operation of choice if we have to perform surgery for patients with corresponding stage. That's it, and thank you.
Спасибо, Дмитрий Андреевич, но вы прошли изменения радиотерапии.
Practically crossed chemoradiotherapy.
И вы в контуре этом продемонстрировали иной материал. Каждая операция, которую вы продемонстрировали, безусловно, это
считается
это
definitely a high tech
и заслуживает большого уважения.
Вашу. And your work deserves great respect. I want to listen to the following. Who made the decision in terms of therapeutic tactics? Surgeon alone or a whole group of doctors? Was pathologist asked? Were all possible tests conducted before surgery? It is a shame, but believe me, regional provincial oncology doesn't always make a decision we want. In this case, the decision was made by surgeons, but when we can, though we are not able always to do this. We invite other experts to take part in decision making. But there are different chemotherapies, the chemoradiotherapies, without going deep into it. But when we say chemoradiotherapy, we certainly prefer to hear specific regimens. I have not analyzed this in detail because I was interested in method on the whole and only long term results. Would have been very interesting to check everything from the point of view of fractioning and how much prior to, afterwards, or at the same time. But 15 minutes presentation didn't allow me to tell all this. I recommend you pay more attention to this in your next presentation so that we would be able to understand better and analyze more. Thank you. In conclusion, maybe I'm wrong, but as far as I know, only in central institutions and clinics, but we have very good planning, 3D planning, and very good radiotherapy. In the regions, they very often use old agas with very high level of mistakes in the dosages. Not everywhere, but there are some regions where they have huge problems with radiotherapy. Certainly, would be nice to offer support to everybody, but the reality is different, unfortunately.